Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can import reviews to your Shopify store and add the widget on your Shopify product page. The reason why I'm creating this video is that adding social validation to your product page, to your store, is really important, because no matter how great the product is, if it is not being validated by social media users, by the reviews which you have on your product page, you are not going to get much of the sales. So it is really important to add authenticity and trust factor on your buyers, whoever is visiting your store in the product page. And in this video, I'll show you an app which is Trusto AI product reviews app, which is a really cool app which you can use completely for free initially, and you can add product reviews and you can import reviews to any of the external app. Meaning, if you are using any other app, you can import reviews into this app very easily if you want to transfer to a different review app. So if I scroll down, you can see that we have these options available in the free tier. So we can send 50 order requests. Order request meaning that this app is going to automatically send a review request to your customer, whoever have bought the products from your store, right? And this is the feature where we can import 20 reviews per product in the free tier. We can show 6 reviews per product. We can also have the discount code feature. The discount feature is applicable when you send a customer review request. You can also add the discount option, meaning you can incentivize your customer that if they add reviews, they will be getting a discount, like 5%, 10%, whatever setting you want to add in for the discount code. We also have the Instagram feed, and we also have the chat support, meaning if you are having issues using this app, because app has a lot of options, you can basically contact chat support in order to understand functionality and how to implement it on your store. So without further ado, let's get into the app backend, where I'm going to show you guys how you can first import the reviews on your store. And I'm also going to show you guys how you can add the review widget on your product page. Guys, you can basically import reviews from any of the app, no matter you're using Judgme, Loox, or any of the other Shopify store reviews app you're using, you can import it easily. In order to import reviews, first you'll have to install the app. To install the app, you can use the link in the description to install the app, right? And once you install the app, which I have already installed, you will see a screen like this. And in order to import the reviews, all you have to do is just go to import reviews. And here you will find the sample Excel file template or the sample CSV file template, right? If you want to directly import the reviews, but if you want to import reviews from the other apps, you can select whatever app you want it to import from. Here we have Shopify product reviews. Here we have Judgme product reviews, Loox product reviews. I don't know how to pronounce this app. Anyway, that's another review app. And Vital product reviews, LAI product reviews, Fera product reviews. So any of the app you want to import it from, just click on that and add the CSV file, export it from that app, and you can import it easily in this app. Now, in the next step, what I'm going to do, I am going to show you how you can add widget on your product page. So if we first go to the dashboard of the app, we will need to first enable that on our theme. And in order to enable that, make sure you click on enable now and enable the app embed. And now guys, you can see that we have this toggled on automatically, and we will now click on save to enable the app embed. Perfect, it is saved now. Now if I go back and hit refresh, you can see that we have the app embed enabled. There we go. And you can see that we have app activated. Now we will add the customer review widget. First, take a look at the widget, whatever settings which we have in the customer widget. And here you can see that we have different layouts. So here we have this professional layout, which will look on the bottom of the product page. And this is the streamlined layout, which is a different type of layout. So you can choose whatever layout you want to add in to your product page, right? And here we have different star styles. So if I click any of the different star, like if I want to change it to the fire icon here, you can see that we have this updated here, right? As per the icon which I selected.
And if I scroll down, we have the sorting option. So if we want to sort it by the newest review, if you want to show newest review on the top, you can do that. You can do that by photo priority. If someone has photo on the review and this one is, then AI, meaning AI will automatically select which one you should display on the top, highest rating or lowest rating. However you want to sort your reviews on this review widget, which will show up on the bottom of the product page, you can do that. Here we have the attribution style. You can see that once we do that, you can see the change happening here, right? So it is for this part. Below we have some other settings like number of reviews, write a review button. So if we want to enable or disable this write a review button, we can simply enable or disable. Or if we want to display this number here, from this number of reviews, we can enable and disable. You can see that it's also changing it here, right? Here we have the option to enable and disable photo album. Here we have photo border radius. So you can see that the border radius of photo is also changing. If you have the rating filter, button border radius. So all of these different settings, which you can lay out completely for free. And also they have a really responsive support. So if you click on this icon here, and if you need any help, you can simply leave out a message here and they'll get back to you in a few minutes, right? So a really responsive. And if you take a look at the number of reviews, you can see that the app has like more than 1300 reviews with the 4.9 star rating. And one other thing I would like to mention on the import review section, if you go to import review section, you can not just only import from the other apps, you can also import it from AliExpress, Amazon import, and sync dropshipman, meaning if you are using any dropshipping platform and importing the products from the dropshipping platform, you can also directly import the reviews from that dropshipping platform to display on your product page. That's also a really cool feature, because if you're running a dropshipping store, you really need to have reviews displayed on your store, and adding reviews manually on the product page is going to take you a lot of time. So you can directly import it from the dropshipping platform. Other than review widget, we also have a lot of different type of widgets, meaning this Q&A widget, which is for question and answer. This is a star rating, which I'm going to show you how to add on the product page. AI summary, meaning it will display the AI summary. Write a review, how you want write a review to look like on your store. So currently that's how the form looks like. You can do some customization here, just like the review widget. And we have card carousel, store review. So basically a lot of features in this app, which is not possible for me to cover in this video. In the rest of the video, I'm going to show you how you can basically add star rating and add product review widget on your product page. So first, let's import some of the reviews, because I don't have any reviews on my products. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to click on import reviews and download this simple CSV file. Let's open up the CSV file. Okay, here we have the CSV file where we have just two reviews. So I'm going to use that for example, right? And I am going to change this rating to 5 as well. So we will get add 2 5-star reviews on our products, right? And this is the product handle. And that is where I will use my own product handle. So if I go to my store and I'm going to add reviews to these two products. So let's click on this one first. And that is my product handle. So I'm going to just copy this here and paste it here. And then go to that other product where I want to add review. Copy the product handle. You can also find out the product handle from the product edit page. So, okay, we have changed the product handle and we will use the rest of the details same for now, just to show you guys how you can import the product reviews. So now let's go back to our import review page and then click on add file. I'm going to import the same file, which I downloaded for the sample purposes. Let's click on open and then click on import reviews. And it says failed to, meaning cannot find this product. Okay, it has some issues with the product handle because I forgot to save the file. So I'm going to save the file. Now let's try re-importing the file by doing the CSV. perfect. You can see that we have two reviews imported. Perfect. And now if I go to the product page, like if I open up this product and hit refresh, you will see that I don't have anything showing up right now. The reason why is that I haven't edit the widget on my product page template. So how you can do that? So let's go to the customize. So I'm gonna exit this, and on my active publish theme, which is the latest version of Horizon theme as of today, version 3.0.1, gonna click on customize and then open up the product page template by clicking on this drop down menu. And I just have one product page template, so I'm going to click on default product, and here is my product page template. I have this product information section. Click on this arrow sign to open that up, and here you will find this plus sign to add the block. And once you click on that, you will have this apps option, and here I am going to search for review because I have multiple apps installed. And here is the Trusto IO review blocks, different blocks which we can add. I'm gonna add star rating widget to show up below the pricing here. So let's add that. And here you can see that we have one review which we imported showing up for this product. I'm gonna drag and drop it below the pricing. Okay. Product title, product price. Okay, in order to display it below the product price, we will have to add it from this plus sign here under the header group, right? So I'm gonna remove it from here and then add it under the header group. So here's this plus sign, click on that, and let's do that again. Perfect, we have this star rating widget showing up, and if I click on save, it should display the star ratings which we have. There we go. You can see that we have one review on this product page which is displayed as of this star rating. And I'm gonna add the product review widget below the main product description and above this you may also like. You can also add it below, but I'm gonna add that above you may also like. So click on add section, click on apps, and here if I search for review, you can see that we have this review widget section showing up, which I'm gonna add. And here you go, you can see that we have this review which we imported is now showing up, right? Now you can change the position based on your requirement, like if you want to display it above you may also like, or if you have any other section, you can simply drag and drop. And if you click on that, you can basically select the product as well if you want to make it for a product specific review. Here we have some settings, like if you want to change the alignment and some other settings which we can use here. But my suggested way to go is to go to manage review or widgets in order to customize your widget from here, right? Now we already added that, so this is also another way. So if you click on add to theme, it is going to directly take you to that app embed page and the section and block page where you can basically add a section and a block. So this star rating is the block which we added, and this is the section which we added on our product page, right? So that one is the block, and this is the review widget section which we added. Now if I click on save and go to my other product as well, you can see that we have this showing up here, and we have the customer review widget. We do not have any review on this product. Why it is not showing up, let me check, because we imported the reviews for these two products. If I go to activewear t-shirt, it is displaying the one review but not on the other product which we imported. So let's see where is our review. So if I click on manage reviews, okay, here it is. It is currently not enabled, so I'm gonna enable that. For some reason it went to the moderation, maybe due to these other reviews which I tried to import and had some issue with that. So I'm gonna enable that. And now let's go back to the product. And there you go. Now you can see that we have this review showing up. Okay, guys, that's it for this video. Unfortunately, it is not possible for me to cover up all of the functionality of this app because this app is too big. And I don't want to bore you guys making such a long video. Let me know in the comments below if you have any confusion. Until next video, have a great day.